Hello there. Welcome to the supply chain universe. Let's dive in.
Let's dive in.
Gartner has focused a lot of attention recently on the need for resilient supply chains, particularly for planning. And Tim Payne makes a statement that we need to move from the unknown uncertainty to known variability. So let's discuss these concepts based on OMK case. OMK has three digital twins, S&OP, MPS, and Shadowing. And globally, a digital twin is a virtual model in the IT system of the physical world.
You're analog players in a digital world.
At the moment, there is no clear formulation of the digital twins term, but they can be divided into several types in terms of application. Firstly, for modeling physical and chemical processes.
Why don't we do a model of the solar system?
This is difficult, expensive, or time-consuming. For example, how something will behave in space.
In space.
Oral processes, for example, drilling wells. And secondly, for modeling the behavior of the physical chain in the future. For example, S&OP. We're making plans for the future using a digital twin. And OMK digital twins of MPS and Shadowing are double twins, that is, not just twins, but also brothers, since they're implemented within a single model framework, like a two-phase genus.
Two-phased?
On the one hand, you might see MPS, and on the other, Shadowing. By the way, write in the comments, how is volatility impacting your company and what would you like to improve about your execution? OMK uses digital twins for decision making, that is, maximizing the money earned at different levels.
Spend all the money I earn?
Uncertainty is various at different levels. However, fundamental reasons are the same everywhere. Our priority is customer variability. There are three main causes of uncertainty.
Burning with uncertainty.
First, that is, the client as a whole becomes more complex and demanding by nature. And we see this at different levels. When we talk about S&OP, this is uncertainty from the point of view of demand forecast. When we speak about MPS, this again indicates that the client is becoming more complex, waiting for prices to rise or fall. And uncertainty in terms of the presence and absence of orders. For example, when it will be placed, the timing of placement. If previously it was mainly set a year in advance, now there are fewer such orders. Customer behavior is difficult to predict.
Get the doctor's here.
Second, orders have now begun to appear on a very short horizon. This is responsiveness. A client arrives today and wants an order tomorrow. This is the first moment. And the second point, that orders are getting smaller. For example, earlier the client came a year before the required month, placed 10,000 tons of a simple product, and now the situation is different. The client comes not in a year before, but in a day earlier, places not one order, but 100 orders, and not for 10,000 tons each, but according to 10 tons each. And each order contains not a simple product, but a product with specific additional requirements. And says, pack with a ribbon, tie a bow.
He's so complex.
Third, from the point of view of operational planning, the primary pain, uncertainty, is change management. That is, the client not only came yesterday, placed an order for pretentious small-sized products, but he also began to change something in the order. The root or reason is the same, that the client becomes more difficult, but this is a neurotic society in which we live.
We live in a very superficial society.
consequently at three levels of planning, S&OP, MPS, and scheduling, this manifests slightly in different places. Demand accuracy, the specifics of orders at the time of their appearance, and last moment, these are changes that come on orders. And if we talk about the reasons, then it is the neuroticism of the client in the society which generates such clients.
The client is a victim of society.
There are five ways to improve supply chain resilience strategies based on OMK case. Number one, OMK has stopped working on improving the accuracy of the demand forecast as a kind of super task, which at one time was. Let's hire a research institute so that it can predict for us what will happen in 5 years.
What did I predict?
This is nonsense. It doesn't work in the modern neurotic world. Number two. Instead, we're following the path of increasing the speed of decision-making, reaction to these changes. That is, the basic principle is to make decisions as late as possible.
You make quick decisions.
So OMK sets up its processes. And what's the difference between OMK and big methodologies? Big methodologies behave when they can afford it. They say, guys, if you want us to ship something to you next month, then transfer your request until the 25th day of the previous month, and we will ship it to you next month. Number three. To work in a neurotic society, OMK takes orders not once a month or a month, but every minute, every hour.
Every hour, every minute, every second.
And from the point of view of the time window, it works in such a way that has abolished the time window. OMK doesn't have a time window month, week, day, unless in a sense you can say day. But OMK works under an adaptive time window. The client said that he wants from the Tuesday 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. and OMK is working on this. Thus, the classic SCM concept of the time window goes away as a class because we work in a neurotic society. Number four, we can say that moving from unknown uncertainty to known variability can be interpreted as a fundamental philosophical reversal. What's unknown uncertainty?
Location unknown.
Unknown?
In our world, this is the entire surrounding world. In this world, you can only change yourself, only your inner attunement. The only decent job in this world is working on yourself.
You can change things about yourself.
And this is a philosophical approach, which in the practical field leads to the fact that no, we're not chasing to change, predict the world. Everything around is unknown, and the further in time, the more it will become unknown. The only thing known is you, and from a business point of view, these are your processes, your company. Therefore, here this unknown uncertainty for me is the unknown of the surrounding world, to the fame of variability. Change here is a positively charged world that I build myself inside to be ready for anything.
Be ready for anything.
This variability isn't me. And uncertainty is around. Number five, and whatever unknown uncertainty is around, I'm ready for any unknown uncertainty with my highest known variability. There is just such a paradigm shift that it is a readiness for anything. And this is applicable from the point of view of the life of a particular person. The only decent job in this world is working on yourself. And this is a fundamental shift. In the 80s, there was some kind of surge, the idea that let's model the world. For example, simulate the weather.
Kenneth, simulate a rainstorm.
But it is impossible to simulate the weather on some reasonable horizon, to build a model. But it is possible to prepare a building for various layouts. Next, a few words about handling variability. Firstly, as Goldred bequeathed to us, we're removing our internal constraints.
I'm not asking to be freed from my constraints.
And what are internal constraints in terms of production plans? In a socialist society, there was a plan for 1 year. In fact, this is a limitation. And the monthly plan is also a limitation. Why should you limit yourself? Secondly, that is, we're narrowing the adoption horizon to the appropriate functional cycles. But, of course, functional cycles of purchases, sales, equipment, operation are limitations. From the point of view of purchases and sales, everything is simpler. But from the point of view of equipment, there is a desire to control this button on the mill every second. Turn the mill on and off.
I'll turn on the ray and you'll turn off the ray.
But this is unrealistic because it is a considerable expense. Thirdly, but one way or another, we remove restrictions for some kind of business shift. Our agility and readiness to manage what we can handle. Our resources, capacities and inventories. We cannot control others. Everything else is an external limitation for us. That is, we narrow this horizon. And now we have practically reached approximate to reasonable need. In other words, even if our production is planned for the next shift and production is in progress, then we receive a signal that, for example, a client has refused an order.
Ah, this is a very important client.
Then, with the appropriate decision-making, we stop this production and don't produce unordered products. And this is almost in real time. Well, either we decide that yes, the client refused, but at the same time, we practically online assess the situation that we will sell this product not to this, but to another client. Then we continue to produce it.
Because every client is our most important client.
Therefore, the greatest variability is, on the one hand, in removing the mental limitations of decision makers, and on the other hand, is on the speed of decision making. So, there you go. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. So please don't forget to subscribe and press the like button. And please comment so that I understand the feedback from you. This is very important to me. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye.